I'm Julie and welcome to Stuff-A-Loons video training. Today I'm going to show you how to do a nice stuffed balloon inside your super stuffer. We're going to add some beautiful decor to it and we're just going to get started.
So there are two ways that we can add our balloon to the super stuffer. The first way showing here is we're going to stretch the neck of the balloon using our fingers over the neck of the super stuffer, making sure that we lock the balloon down nice and tight. And then checking all the final little edges of the balloon, and it's ready to go ahead and blow up. The next way is using what we call a neck extender. We put the balloon into the prongs and pull it apart. It stretches the neck of the balloon, then we need to turn the balloon inside out, push it down, get it all nice and neat underneath. And then we're going to pop that onto the neck of the super stuffer. It's nice and simple, we just push that down, lock it into place, double check that all the parts of the balloon are now sitting onto the neck of the super stuffer and off of the neck extender, open the neck extender and remove. And the balloon is ready to stuff. So here we are, the balloon is in and we're going to press the button and blow our balloon up. Now it is important that we make sure that our balloon reaches the outside edges of our super stuffer. So double check that your balloon is completely blown up inside the machine. Then we're going to put a skirt around the neck of the balloon to protect our balloon neck whilst we're filling our balloon. So we're going to tuck that down nice and neatly, get it all nice and tidy, and we're ready to start putting things into our balloon. So for this balloon, I'm going to be putting in some 5-inch balloons that I've already blown up. So I'm just going to pop them through the neck of the super stuffer, just gently manipulating them, moving them around and popping them in. From the top you can see they're quite tight, but as long as you're just manipulating that balloon, you can easily pop them in there. You can fill as many of those balloons into the balloon as you'd like to secure and move around whatever toy you're going to put in. So I'm just putting a nice It's a Girl bunny rabbit into the balloon now. So I've pushed it in, putting it down. Now you can see I've got some cotton attached to the ears of that bunny rabbit. So now I'm just positioning all my balloons around my bunny rabbit to hold him in place. And I'm pulling his ears up to keep him where I want him in the balloon. So you can see my balloon looks nice and full now, and I'm going to take off my skirt, making sure I'm holding on to that cotton. I'm going to double check that my balloon is fully inflated inside the stuffer before I remove the neck of the balloon. So I'm just carefully going to take off the neck of the balloon now, removing it from the super stuffer. Again, I've grabbed my cotton and placed my cotton, and now I've pulled up my teddy bear. And I'm going to start twisting the neck of the balloon to seal it. So I'm twisting it around, I'm giving it a good half a dozen to a dozen twists to make sure it's nice and solid. And then I'm going to get some quickie clips. These are just a little plastic clip, and I'm going to put two of those onto my balloon. One facing one direction, and then I'm going to grab another one, and I'm going to put that in the other direction. So my balloon is well and truly sealed, and then I'm going to allow the top to come up, and there's my balloon. I can now remove the balloon, and put it onto the workspace where I'm going to continue to dress my balloon and decorate it. First thing I do before I start decorating is I'm going to polish my balloon. Makes it nice and crystal and shiny. I have my cotton glove here that I'm going to put onto my hand. I'm going to hold the top of my balloon and I'm now going to polish my balloon. So polish your balloon all the way around, making sure that it's nice and crystal clear. This adds a beautiful finish and helps protect the exterior of your balloon. There's our balloon looking nice and polished. Now I'm going to start adding some decor to my balloon. So I've got 2 5-inch balloons joined together for the first part of my collar for my balloon, and I'm just attaching those around the clips that I've already put on to seal my balloon, and now I'm adding another 2. So whatever my colour is, I'm going to put these balloons up around, and that's created a collar. Now I'm going to add my foil balloon. I'm using the ribbon and just wrapping it around the 5-inch balloon collar to seal it and get it nice and locked in nice and tight onto that collar. Now I can move my balloon around, just position it where I want it to sit, move my balloons around a little bit till I'm happy with that. Now, if you wanted to, you could leave this balloon just as it is and take off those little stray pieces of ribbon that are there. But we're going to keep going because we'd like to see our balloon looking even a little bit more fancier than that. So now I'm going to get some curling ribbon, and before I put that curling ribbon onto my balloon, I'm going to curl it. So it's all ready to go and I'm not playing around my balloon with a pair of scissors. So I'm going to get it all curled up nicely to start with, and then I'm going to place it in and around my balloon. So I've locked them again down again using my collar, and now I'm going to add a nice bouquet to the top of it to give it that extra polished finish. So each step that you add to your stuffed balloon creates you value added. So every time you've put something new onto your balloons and onto your stuffed balloon, you've created another piece of value for your customer. Always remember when you're doing a balloon bouquet on top to curl that ribbon as well. And here's our finished balloon. Absolutely gorgeous piece of decor on top of your stuffed balloon, and it's value added for your customer, and I think when that's delivered to the hospital, they're going to absolutely adore that.